Previously on Oh Grow Up.
Wait a minute. You're going to be here for Christmas?
Yeah.
Ah, so if your mom's cool with us spending the holidays together, I guess that means she's not mad at me anymore.
Surprise! Mom! Oh, I missed you.
Well, Julie!
What the hell are you doing here?
This is an important night. Everything has to be perfect.
Look at me! Spraying cheese down my pants!
What's going on?
I'm going back to San Diego with my mom.
We need to do what's best for our daughter.
Hunter, you are not Chloe's father.
Norris, aren't you supposed to turn in the headset when you clock out at Arby's?
For your information, I am now working as a psychic buddy, which is how they're letting me repay the $600 debt I racked up receiving psychic advice and then falling asleep before I hung up. So, still no sign of Hunter?
Oh, poor thing. He must be heartbroken about Chloe not really being his daughter.
No, I'm worried about him. He's not so great at dealing with his emotions. Remember back in school when Mindy Whitmore dumped him?
Oh, God, he bought that Suzanne Vega album. Listened to it over and over. My name is Hunter. I live on the second floor.
Okay, that's him. Now, listen, we have to help him out here. He's trapped in a downward spiral. It's our job to pull him out of it.
Hey, everybody. This is Rhonda.
Hi.
Norris, remember the thing that you said, how you hate strip clubs because you can't really bring the girls home? Well, you are so wrong.
Hey, I don't go home with just any guy. He's got to have a job, a car, no facial tattoos. Unless he's a doctor.
We were worried about you, buddy. Why? I mean, I'm finally back to the old Hunter. No more of that boring old responsible dad stuff. You know, sure, I'm a little tired and a little dehydrated, and I've got a few more rug burns than usual, but you only go around once.
Or in Rhonda's case, once an hour. Just kidding, darling. You look great.
Hunter, you spoken to Chloe about everything that's going on?
Hey, I've been busy. Oh, that reminds me. Rhonda has invited us all down to the Jiggle Hut for the Christmas buffet.
It's a nice value. $12 gets you all you can eat and a Jell-O dance.
Suzanne and I are going to have to take a rain check on the five-star cuisine down at the Jiggle Hut. We're going to my folks in Chicago for Christmas.
Ford, we never discussed that.
Well, just we went to your folks last year. Plus, I've already bought your first-class ticket and my coach ticket.
Hello? We're separated. I think it's time we started spending holidays apart. You go to Chicago, I'll stay in New York, and when the time is right, you can cash in my ticket and give me the money.
Uh-oh. Gotta get back to the club. Hey, you're pretty. Wanna make some extra money?
Like I'd ever go back to... I have no interest in that.
Some way I could at least finish out the rest of the school year here?
Chloe, I don't like us being so far apart. And besides, I haven't sold a house in months. NYU is just too expensive for me right now.
Well, I could get a job. Or take out a loan. Or start a website where freaks pay to watch me organize my underwear.
Honey, it's just not possible. Besides, is it really so awful to come back home to your boring old mom? I swear I won't drag you to Lilith Fair this year. It's okay. I'm just gonna miss my life here. I better call Hunter and see if he can have lunch tomorrow. I have to say goodbye. He's my dad. Yeah, of course. Okay. Just make it quick, because we've got a lot of packing to do. Relax, it's just a car backfiring. What? That's just one car backfiring at another.
Hunter, I'm sorry to drop in on you like this. I tried to call, but your line's been busy for a day and a half. Could we talk privately?
Sure. But I'll still know what you're saying. I'm psychic.
Hunter, I need to ask you a favor.
Yeah, well, you've already taken the thing that matters most to me, so I guess I do owe you one.
Look, I know you're having lunch with Chloe. Please don't tell her that you're not her father.
You haven't told her?
No, and I'm not going to till we're back in San Diego. She's been through enough already this week.
Fine, fine. You know what? You do me a favor. You let me know when you tell her so that I can at least talk to her about it.
You know, I think it'd be best if you weren't a part of Chloe's life at all.
Well, I think it would be best if you kiss my ass. I'm already a part of Chloe's life.
You know, this isn't about you. When you look at Chloe, you see a terrific young woman, and it makes you feel that you've accomplished something. Well, you had nothing to do with that, Hunter. And if you had, do you really think she'd be the person she is today?
Where do you get off judging me? You don't even know me!
Wow. Hope a dance in a cage will help take the edge off this hangover. Oh, hey, there's a black leather G-string around here. If you find it, hang on to it. Graduation present. Hi.
How can you possibly think you're a good influence on my daughter?
Dude, you okay?
No. No, I'm not okay. I'm a loser. I suck as a human being. And Chloe will be way better off without me in her life.
Come on, Hunter. Hunter, that's not true. Come on. Talk to me.
Leave me alone.
Aim high, class of 98.
Hunter.
Hey, Sal. What are you doing?
I've just ordered my Christmas dinner for tomorrow. I'm not going home. I had a little falling out with one of my narrow-minded cousins.
Oh, about you being gay?
No, about khaki pants. I like pleated. He likes plain front. We can't be in the same room.
Well, Sal, why don't you come to our place for Christmas dinner?
All right, hey, that'd be great. Thanks. Hey, cancel a ho-ho hoagie.
Oh, hey, honey.
Hi.
You remember my boss, Sal?
Of course. He offered me a box of nails for a part in my student film.
What? I got a dream. See you tomorrow, Pally.
I'm glad you could have lunch today. Mom and I are leaving tomorrow.
What? On Christmas Day? Wow, she's not wasting any time getting you out of here.
Well, come on, it's not like I'm never gonna see you again. Hey, I wanted a dad my whole life. I'm not letting you off the hook that easy. What did I say?
Nothing. Hey, and look, you know, I bet you're not even gonna wanna see me once you get back to San Diego. I mean, with the school and the friends and the zoo with the panda. Oh, man, once you see that panda, you are gonna be like, Hunter, who?
Yeah, right. Why'd you come out for a long weekend next month?
No, you know, it's kind of our busy season at the construction company. Yeah, because, you know, if one of the guys slips and falls, the snow is like nature's pillow.
Okay, then I'll come here. Mom doesn't even have to know about
it. No, that's not a good idea.
Okay, what's going on? You're mad at me because I'm moving back with my mom, so you never want to see me again?
No, no, God, that's not it.
Then what is it?
Look, it's complicated.
No, I think it's pretty clear. Thanks, Dad.
Understand why you and Ford had to split up. It's so public.
Aunt Brooke, Ford is gay.
So?
Your Uncle Max and I have been married for 30 years, and he's as gay as the day is long. He's got his towel boys at the club. I've got my bag boys at D'Agostino's. Everybody wins.
But I modeled my marriage after yours. You were the perfect couple with the ballroom dancing and the prize-winning roses and the Welsh corgis named Rogers and Hammerstein.
Oh, you poor dear. You know, D'Agostino's is open till 11. Use the express checkout. Ask Gregory to double bag it. He'll know what to do.
Hey, Uncle Ford.
Hey, Tyler. How was Little League last summer?
Great. My daddy says you played baseball, too. He says you're a catcher for the other team.
Hey, why don't you go ask your daddy how he lost your entire college fund up his nose?
Okay.
Okay.
Daddy! Hey, Daddy!
Oh, Delford, come on. You were not abducted by aliens. No, I'm not saying that you didn't receive a probe. Just saying, don't leave the trailer door unlocked when you got a gut full of cough syrup. Oh, hey, Sal, hi.
Hey, Norris. I brought you a couple of pies.
Oh, well, thanks. Merry Christmas.
What are you doing? I'm supposed to eat here.
Oh, sorry, sorry. Come on in. Hunter didn't tell me that he invited you. Chloe's leaving today. He's a wreck. He's up in his room listening to Suzanne Vega.
My name is Hunter. I live on the second floor.
What happened to you? They run out of cots at the shelter?
Hello, Psychic Buddy Hotline. We care deeply. Visa or MasterCard.
I'm sorry, Sal. I forgot I invited you for Christmas. Forgot it was Christmas. You are Sal, right?
No, I can't believe this. My psychic supervisor called. They're gonna dock me half the hours I've worked because apparently I was too hostile to some of these idiots. Yeah. Hello, this is your psychic, and I'm going to guess only, buddy. Your love life? I see painful genital warts. Merry Christmas. It might be your last.
Now, I'm no Martha Stewart, but I think this bird needs a little more time.
See? You see? I forgot to thaw the turkey. I really am worthless.
Oh, hey. It's a Christmas card from my fourth stepfather, Mel. Check it out. Santa's stranded in the Andes and he's eating a reindeer. Oh, hey, $5 inside.
$5? Why even bother?
God, I haven't seen Mel in years. Well, I think I caught a glimpse of him on Cops, but he wasn't wearing pants and they pixelated out his face.
He sounds like a real winner.
Hey, he's a good guy. He was only married to my mom for a few months, but he still keeps in touch with me. I know he's not my real dad, and maybe he's not much of a role model, but he stuck with me. It made an important difference in my life.
I gotta get to the airport. Chloe's plane leaves in 40 minutes.
What?
Look, I'm not her real dad, and I suck at being a role model, but I got $5, and I could get one of those stupid cards on the way.
It's a nice story. How much did you make up?
Well, Mel exists, but the card's from my dentist. I'm due for a cleaning. And I borrowed the $5 from your wallet.
Somebody stole my car. Or I left it at the Jiggle Hut. Look, Sal, you're driving us to the airport. Come on.
I got toll money. Suzanne, what are you doing here?
Hitting bottom, but it's still better than having an Edward Albee Christmas with my family. Where are you guys going?
To the airport to find Chloe.
Come on, hurry!
Look, my truck's a little cramped, so somebody's gonna have to sit on the pneumatic drill in the back.
Shotgun. Oh.
We haven't missed them.
You know, I could have got here a lot faster if I had the snowplow in the truck. It cuts through toll booths like butter.
Just when I thought my life couldn't get any more pathetic, I'm spending Christmas at LaGuardia. Ooh, duty free.
Hey, I'll go with you. Ma's out of camels.
Hey, there they are. Chloe. Hey, I have something to tell you before you leave.
Hey, Hunter, I thought we agreed.
Julie, this is between me and Chloe, okay? Hurry, we don't have much time.
But Hunter, we...
Listen, wait, just let me finish. Look, I know with you out in California, it's gonna be hard for me to be like a real dad. But anytime you need anything, anytime you want to come visit me, anytime you want me to come visit you, anytime you need anything, I'm here for you. And I always will be. Okay, now, what were you gonna tell me?
Just that our flight's delayed, so you can take your time.
Oh, well, actually, I'm pretty much done.
Hunter, I don't want to go back to San Diego.
Then don't.
Chloe, we talked about this. I can't afford New York.
I'll pay.
You'll pay? Even after what we talked about?
Yes, yes, it doesn't matter.
NYU is 25 grand a year.
What?
No, not you, Jethro. Find a good trade school and try not to cut off your hand.
Look, Julia, I have some money saved, and I don't need a DVD player, and I spoil Norris way too much. Look, if it'll make Chloe happy, I'll do whatever it takes.
Mom, I know you've given up so much for me. And I really love you. But I'm staying in New York. And I guess it's settled.
Hey, guys! Look at what I found in Duty Free, along with 100-proof vodka that you're not supposed to shake.
Ford, why aren't you in Chicago?
I had a lousy time. It was freezing, the turkey was dry, and, well, somehow my brother-in-law's nasty coke habit came up.
You know, I had a terrible time, too. And by the way, that awkward moment that you had with my Uncle Max in the bathroom, it wasn't your imagination. I'm sorry for making us spend time with our families.
Yeah, that's not what the holidays should be about.
Hey, this sea bass isn't bad for airport food.
Yeah, that's cornbread.
Hey, how come you're not finishing your fries?
I'm full.
Well, then you should have ordered a medium. We're on a budget, mister. We have a kid to put through school. You are not getting a Mr. Octopi for dessert.
Malcolm?
Hunter, about the school thing, thank you. I'm so glad you finally know about Dad. Feels really good not having to lie anymore.
Chloe. There's something that your mom and I need to tell you.
Yeah, but, not until after we check my flight. Hunter?
Oh, no.
Hey, if I have a brother somewhere, I get half his stuff.
Hello, this is your psychic Sal. No, this isn't a suicide hotline.
No, it's, you know, that happens all the time, Sal. Just hang up on him.
Hunter, if I did something really bad because I thought it would help Chloe, would you understand?
Hey, how you paid for Huggies and formula is your business.
Look, Hunter, I lied. You are Chloe's father.
What?
I know, I'm sorry. It's the worst thing I ever could have done. I guess I was just seeing you through the eyes of an angry, pregnant 16-year-old, and I didn't see you for who you really are until tonight.
So Chloe really is my daughter? I should be really furious with you right now. But I'm a dad!
So you forgive me?
No!
Well, how about if I paid for half of Chloe's tuition?
That would help. That would help a lot. Because I had no idea where I was going to get all that money. And Norris really does need a new outfit. Look, you know, you realize you made my life hell.
Thank you.
Wow. Rangers beat the Flyers 4-2.
Called it.
House passes transportation bill.
Called it.
86-pound tumor removed from woman in Nebraska?
Called it. State and weight.
Hey, buddy. How you doing?
Pretty damn good.
How's it going, guys? Well, I think I'm gonna go jump in the shower.
Well, I think I'm gonna go jump in the shower.
Wow, didn't call that.